Hi everyone, I would like to thank Professor Ayman Rifai and the Egyptian Society of Nephrology and Transplantation Board for inviting me today to talk about IT-based interventions on self-management in adult kidney transplant recipients. As we know, kidney transplantation is the optimal therapy for end-stage kidney disease. Long-term graft survival depends on complex complementary approach of healthcare monitoring of graft function and individual self-management. Self-management, it is a set of approaches which help a patient manage his own health. Health information technology has the potential to empower patients. Self-management, in fact, is an integrated process. It is a shared process between individual, his family, and his community, and his healthcare system. All complement each other to reach the good achievement. Self-management skills for kidney transplant recipients include self-monitoring of body weight, blood pressure, body temperature, urine output, self-care behavior of balanced low-calorie fresh food, cut down sodium, mouth hygiene, hand washing, clean house, early detection of graft issues, as regard monitor declining of graft function, track immune suppression side effects and timing, stress management, sufficient sleep rest, sufficient support, and if needed, specialist and group discussion. As regards the healthcare system, we all know that informatic and the first human database started since ancient Egyptian era. In the Egyptian dynasty, 6,000 years before Christ, we have a lot of information written on the walls of temples, and those information have been analyzed to create sophisticated equations. And those equations also have been taught to students and learned to end with the famous Egyptian royal cubit, which actually a prediction model. We have nowadays new advanced tools in the form of computer-based programs, tablet-based programs, smartphone-based programs to store and analyze the data. At the Urology Nephrology Center, Mansoura University, Egypt, we realized the importance of the digital transformation of the hard copy of our electronic medical information and records. Since 1998, all transmitted in 2 years to a digital form. After transforming the medical information, we started a complex multivariant Cox-based regression analysis, and we constructed our first nomogram to be enabled to predict the graft function. This nomogram is very, while it is complex in formation, computer constructed, but it is simple for the physician and the patient to utilize. It includes recipient age, donor age, haplotype mismatch, time to diuresis, total steroid dose in the first 3 months, immune suppression in the first 3 months, and if there is any unplanned event of ATN or acute rejection. We have many factors that can be customized and improved even before transplantation, like selecting the donor age and the haplotype mismatch. Also, the plan for the initial immune suppression also can affect the graft survival. Each one of these risk factors earn a certain number of risk, and when total points of risk calculated, it can be used to estimate the graft survival on the lower red scale, and you can have 1 year up to 5 year graft survival from the nomogram. Very easy, and even it can be done on a printed paper. This nomogram is one of the decision supporting tools, and after that it emerges the artificial intelligence technology. So we challenged ourselves, and we used our patient data collected on our server. We did a data processing, data mining process, and we did build a lot of models, selected the optimal one for knowledge deployment, and then compared our constructed neural network model with the already published nomogram. And we have a new publication in the Transplant Journal, Transplantation Journal, Prediction of Graft Survival of Living Donor Kidney Transplantation Nomograms or Artificial Neural Networks. Our paper has got acknowledgement from the transplantation sector of the Nature and also a commentary in the transplantation for an always promising transplant prediction called ANN. Actually, after that, a lot of models emerged from USA, Japan, Australia, Italy, and we are the only one from our region, from the Middle East, to have the honor to be among the leaders in this field and to represent Egypt and all the Arab world in that field. Our model has been criticized, evaluated from many respective universities, and now it is on the top and one of the pillars of artificial intelligence and transplantation. Then on COVID-19 pandemic, we have this new consultation through the internet, the virtual consultation. It is simply that we are using the camera and the microphone of our computer in the clinic and be connected with the patient elsewhere from his computer, and through the internet, we can see his radiology. We can even do a clinical exam through the camera, and we can prescribe the medication according to our decision, with the limitation of the virtual consultation, but it is now considered one of the most important self-management tools. This is a true example from one of the software available in the Gulf. We can see here in the waiting area, we can see the physical patients waiting outside the outpatient clinic, and we can see the other patients having the icon for a camera, so they are a virtual patient. So once the time for the virtual patient comes, the physician can call him through application on the phone and can be connected visually to his physician, reviewing all the medical data and even prescribing the medication. At the individual level now, most of the patients having home blood pressure monitoring and even insurance company agree to give every patient with 3 readings of high blood pressure a machine at home, because home monitoring is considered one of the tools now to ideal tools to measure blood pressure. Also, self-monitoring of blood glucose in 2020, Kidugi recommendations, they recommend self-monitoring of blood glucose either on intermittent or real-time or retrospective CGM for patients of chronic kidney disease stage 4 and 5 due to the bias in the measurement of hemoglobin A1C. We have 3 types of continuous glucose monitoring: retrospective, that means that the machine is measuring all the measures and then it is can be seen after detaching the machine from the patient later on. It is a retrospective real time, that the machine at any time can have a reading from the machine while he's putting the batch for reading. Intermittent, the machine can at intermittent times, it is also called the flash CGM, can have reading through his mobile phone or a special app for the machine. After getting that reading, there is glucose management indicator. It provides a measure of average blood glucose levels calculated from CGM reading expressed in units of A1C, so it can overcome the falsely high or low A1C measured levels. We have also a new stethoscope that can connect to the computer and can send the information directly to the physician when the patient can use at home, or a younger physician need to consult his consultant senior. As well, as you all know, since a long time, we have the Holter monitor for patients with cardiac diseases and arrhythmia can be used also at home. As regards the encourage medication compliance, as we have a high rate of uncompliant for medication in our transplant, especially long-term transplant recipients, I will not talk in detail because I know the lecture before me is about this issue, but I will give you only a hint about the IT application. This simple app, personal medical adherence app, that the physician or the patient can put in the sectors his medication with the proper timing and according to the days through the week. And if the patient forget to take his medication or document that he took already the medication, it give you alarm through the light, sound, phone call, text message, even can send email. Also, it is connected to his caregiver, either physician or a nurse, that can verify his medication. And also, it is connected to his family that they can have also message and can encourage him or alert him that he missed or take wrongly his medication. We have also a web-based complementary program that can include all the items of the self-management. And it gives a score ranging from well to bad. And according to the score, you can predict the outcome of the patient and his progression. It includes daily activity, work, family, friend, and social network, intimate relationships, transport, mobility, leisure, activity, self-care, household chores, finance, dealing with treatment recommendation, lifestyle, symptoms, side effect, shared decision-making, illness-related knowledge, emotions giving meaning to life. We have a lot of publications concerned with the self-management impact on the patient and the graft survival, and most of them came with positive effect. Most of them are centered on computer-based educational programs, tablet-based programs, and smartphone-connected programs. And if we look to the tablet and the smartphones, it is always deal with communication, and it is interactive more than the computer-based. Future perspectives of healthcare, artificial intelligence applications. We have this researcher from Toronto is working on developing a selfie-based blood pressure monitor. We all know that we have this visual monitoring every day since the pandemic of COVID-19. And he is working on to have also a selfie-based blood pressure monitor. So the patient, while he is entering the healthcare facility, the blood pressure can be taken from the cameras all over the facility and alarm him if his blood pressure is high. And also can be done through shopping malls and in the public transportation. It can give the patient alarm that his blood pressure is under control, preventing in the future the high rate of strokes, the emergency and the urgency of hypertension in the ER. Also, we have this Japanese hospital-based Suki program that can help young physicians, resident, and even the consultant through taking the complaint of the patient, analyzing the complaint, giving a guide to the approach and the proper prescription of safe medication without interaction. We have also a new technology coming through the radiology, the ultrasound design for the future using augmented reality. Augmented reality means that while you are using the ultrasound, either to monitor the graft or the renal native kidneys, it can guide you to have the best picture of the kidney. Also, it is connected to a cloud technology and can be seen by other physicians in another location all over the world. So even if the patient having an emergency and he went to a public facility, with no transplant expert, he can do the ultrasound with the radiologist, and the radiologist immediately shares the knowledge with his transplant expert. Take home message. As you can see, the IT-based interventions, either computer-based, tablet-based, smartphone-based, have the potential to improve self-management in adolescent and young adult kidney transplant recipients. Thank you very much.